ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. To everyone watching, of course, as you know that this is the time of suhoor, the time to wake up, to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to take some food and prepare for this journey of fast that we will take throughout the day. Brothers and sisters, we have been talking about Iman, alhamdulillah, and what is the definition of Iman? What does Iman entail? And not only that, yesterday we talked about the halawatul Iman, the sweetness of Iman. Today, inshallah, I want to talk about what are the benefits of Iman. See, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us, He has created you and I, and we are hence the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we are the slaves of Allah, Allah could have easily told us, you are my slave, you have to worship me, and you have to do what I tell you to do. And in return, Allah, if He wanted, He did not have to do anything for us. The fact that we find in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam benefits of Iman, this is purely from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about this. As a parent, when you tell your child to do something, and for every single thing, if they came to you and they said, I want a reward, then we would tell them that, no, you do this because we're telling you to do this. Not necessarily there's going to be a reward every single time you do something. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters, is so merciful that Allah tells us that whenever you have Iman, whenever you come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever what you say verbally, it exists in your heart and you firmly believe in it, then there are benefits and there are rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So today, inshallah, and tomorrow, I want to talk about some of those benefits and what are the fruits of Iman. Once again, Allah talks about that Iman is like that tree. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا كَلِمَةً طَيِّبًا كَشَجْرَةٍ طَيِّبًا. And what does a tree do? It bears fruits. So this is what we're talking about, the fruits and the benefits of Iman. The very first thing, brothers and sisters, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that verily when it comes to those who are the friends of Allah, who are the allies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who have taken upon themselves this journey to come close to Allah, they become the wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are the ones who are close to Allah. Allah says regarding those people, لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. By the way, this is an ayah, or we hear many ayahs in the Quran like this. There is no fear upon them and there is no grief. And a lot of times we don't understand and we don't ponder upon the beauty of the Quran. See, if there is one thing that we always are worried about is the future. What's going to happen tomorrow? What's going to happen tomorrow? Will I have a job? Where will I be in 5 years? Where will I be in 10 years? Where are my children going to be in 5 to 10 years? We always have fear about the future. And there's always grief and sorrow about the past. I wish I had done this. Or had I done this, today I would probably be in a different situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when it comes to the wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no fear about the future and there is no grief about the past. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. Who is this for? Those who have Iman and those who have taqwa. So when we have Iman and we put our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will inshaAllah take care of our future. Allah will take care of our past. Remember the story, brothers and sisters, about Musa and Khadr. The story that we find in Surah Al-Kahf, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that Khidr went and he erected a wall. And when Musa alayhi salam asked him that the people of the city have refused to give us food, and yet you're doing them a favor, what did he say? He says, كَانَ تَحْتَهُ كَنْزٌ لَهُمَا وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا. That beneath this wall there is a treasure that belongs to two children whose father has passed away. But what do we learn from this ayah? This was a man who had iman. This was a man who did righteous deeds. And because of that, Allah protected the future of his kids also. Subhanallah. So this is what Allah says to us in the Quran. This is the very first benefit of having iman. The second benefit of having iman is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes not only the protector, Allah also becomes the wali of those people who have iman. Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allahu waliyul ladhina amanu. Allah becomes the wali of those people who have iman. And what does he do as a result? يُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. He takes them out from darkness to light. What does that mean? He takes them out from the darkness of disobedient to the light of iman. He takes them out from the darkness of ignorance and he brings them to the light of knowledge and ilm. He takes them out from the darkness of sins to the light of obedience. And he takes them out from the darkness of ghafla and negligence to the light of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning that Allah does, what does he do? He takes a person out of the darkness and he brings them to light. Subhanallah. And this is exactly what Allah says, that this is for those who have iman. Next, the third benefit that we learn from having iman is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he becomes merciful towards these people. Allah has mercy upon these people. Allah says in Surah Bara'ah or Surah Tawbah, Al-mu'minuna wal-mu'minat ba'duhum awliya'u ba'd. The believing men are allies towards one another. The believing women are allies towards one another. What does that mean? That a believer is a protector of another person. A believer protects the interest, the honor, the dignity of another Muslim brother and sister. This is why we find in other ahadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has emphasized that taking care of the honor and the dignity, the property and the blood of another Muslim is sacred. So what does a believer do? They take care of others. It doesn't mean we don't take care of others. We take care of everyone and we pay close attention to those who are our brothers and sisters. And he says then what? يُؤْمِنُونَ He says يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. What do these people they do? The believing men and the believing women, they enjoin towards good. وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَلْ الْمَعْرُوفِ. And they stop other people from committing sins and doing wrong. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. They establish their prayers. وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ. They give charity and they give their zakat. وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. And they obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they obey the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ. Indeed, and down the road in the future, most certainly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy upon these people. And beautifully in the next ayah, Allah says, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ جَنَّاتِ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِ الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا وَرِضْوَانٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. Subhanallah. Allah tells us that another sign of, or another benefit or fruit of having iman is that Allah will give this person Jannah. And more than Jannah, now if I were to ask you, is there something even greater than Jannah? And the answer is yes. There's something even greater than Jannah. And what is that? وَرِضْوَانٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. And it is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is going to be pleased with these people who have iman. So this is why it is very important that we try to do everything and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us for amongst the believers, Amin Rabbil Alameen. The fourth benefit today, inshallah, that I will share with you. So the very first one that we talked about was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is taking care of your future and you should not have any grief about the past. The second thing is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes the wali and hence He takes these people out of darkness and He brings them to light. The third one was that Allah will have mercy upon them, and as a result, Allah will give them Jannah and Allah will be pleased with them. And the fourth benefit that I want to share with you today is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide His help and His salvation, and He will protect the believers, those who have iman, from evils and calamities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hajj, He says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah says that indeed Allah defends those who have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once again, a person who simply says La ilaha illallah, a person who does not have Allah in their heart, then they do know that Allah is the protector, but they don't believe in the fact that Allah is truly the protector. But when you and I, when we know that Allah is the one who is the protector, إِن يَنْصُرْكُمُ اللَّهُ فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ. If Allah helps, no one can overpower you. No one can overcome you. This is even what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he even taught Ibn Abbas, a child. He says, وَعَلَمْ لَوْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوَجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ إِن يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ. If everyone got together and they tried to benefit a person, Allah does not want that person to be benefited, they cannot benefit him. And if everyone got together and they try to harm one person, and Allah does not want this person to be harmed, no one can harm this person. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, those who have iman, Allah will stand by their side. Allah will defend them. In fact, going back to the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also said, إِحْفَظِ اللَّهَ تَجِدْهُ تُجَاهَكَ. That protect Allah. What does it mean to protect Allah? It means to protect the orders of Allah, to maintain the orders of Allah. And if you do that, Allah will be on your side. Allah will always take care of you. So likewise, Allah will not only protect this person, Allah will defend this person, but not only that, Allah will save this person. Allah saves the believers from calamities. How do we know this? We find in the Quran the story of Yunus alayhi salam. فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَلَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Yunus alayhi salam, he understands he has made a mistake. So what does he do? He praises Allah and he admits to his mistake. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك. O Allah, there is none worthy of worship but you. سبحانك, glory be you. إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. I am indeed from the wrongdoers. And what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? Allah says, فَاسْتَجَبَنَا لَهُ. We responded to his call. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِ. And we protected him. And we saved him from that calamity. Now when you and I, when we hear that, the first thing that comes to our mind is what? I'm not Yunus. So how does this benefit me? Allah says, if we continue to read on, Allah says, وَكَذَٰلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah saves those who have iman. Allah will save those who have iman. So this is why there are so many benefits of having iman. So this is why it is so important that we do those things that can bring iman into our life. There's so many things that we can do to bring iman, to increase our iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, we'll go through that. But I want to also go through today some of the benefits of iman. What do you and I, we get? Because as human beings, we're always incentive driven. I want to know the benefits. How do I benefit from this? And then I may do it. So Allah is telling us that these are the benefits of iman. And if you do it this way, inshallah, you'll get these benefits. And there are many other benefits that we will get, which I will share with you all tomorrow, inshallah. As I've done yesterday, inshallah, I'm going to be making some dua. And once again, you can either follow with me, say ameen. Once again, this is the time of suhoor. Or if you're watching this any other time of the day, you can make the same du'as. These are very important du'as that we learn from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today, I have chosen some ayat of guidance. So we will be making those ayat. And these are found in the Quran and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The very first one is from Surah Al-Kahf. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مِلَّ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةٌ وَهَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا. O Allah, grant us from yourself mercy and prepare us from our affair, right guidance. Next, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, there's a dua that I would like to share with you also, is Ya Muqallib al Qulub, O Turner of the Hearts, Thabbit Qulubana ala Deenik, O Allah, keep our hearts firm upon your path. And then next one is Ya Musarrif al Qulub, Sarrif Qulubana ala Ta'atik, O Director of the Hearts, direct our hearts towards good deeds. Allah subhanahu, we also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma rahmataka arju fala takilni ila nafsi tarfata ayn. O Allah, it is your mercy that I hope for, so do not leave me in charge of my affairs for the blink of an eye. Wa aslih li sha'ni kullah. This is a dua that we all should be making. O Allah, rectify for me all my affairs. O Allah, everything that I am related to, associated with, O Allah, we ask you to please correct our affairs. La kulla, la ilaha illa anta. There is none worthy of worship but you. O Allah, only you can correct and take care of my affairs. And finally, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the same du'as that we made yesterday to Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, we ask Allah, do not let our hearts deviate after you have given us guidance. وَحَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً. O Allah, we ask you to grant us mercy from you. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابِ. O Allah, you are the one who is the one who bestows upon other people. اللَّهُمَّ حَبِّبْ إِلَيْنَا الْإِيمَانَ. O Allah, make beloved to us our faith and iman. وَزَيِّنْهُ فِي قُلُوبِنَا. O Allah, beautify it in our hearts. وَكَرِّهْ إِلَيْنَا الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصِيَانَ. O Allah, we ask you to make disbelief, wickedness and disobedience hateful in our hearts. Allahumma ja'alna min rashideen. O Allah, we ask you to make us from amongst those who are guided. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inna kunna min al-zalimeen. O Allah, we admit and we say that there is none worthy of worship but you, and glorify you be, O Allah, indeed we are from those who have committed wrong. O Allah, we ask you to forgive us in the month of Ramadan. O Allah, we ask you to accept our du'as in the month of Ramadan. And finally, I want to share a du'a with all of you, that anyone who makes this du'a, and then whatever they ask for afterwards, inshallah, Allah will accept our du'as. Allahumma inni as'aluka bi anna laka alhamdu, la ilaha illa anta al-mannan, badi'u as-samawati wal-ard, ya dhal jalali wal-ikram, ya hayyu ya qayyum. Make this du'a, brothers and sisters. Allahumma inni as'aluka bi anna laka alhamd, la ilaha illa anta al-mannan, badi'u as-samawati wal-ard, ya dhal jalali wal-ikram, Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. You make this dua inshallah, and the Prophet ﷺ says that anything that you ask after this, Allah will accept it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our du'as. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase in our iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us strong iman. And may I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that as a result of these iman, may Allah give us the benefits of iman, the taste and the sweetness of iman. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Inshallah, tomorrow we'll be doing the same, and we'll also be making some du'a at the end, because this is the time of suhoor. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of us good in this dunya, in the akhirah. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Till tomorrow, Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون.